Welcome to Infinite Environments, a totally unique physical space that will transport your mind and your body both visually, sonically, and viscerally to places beyond your imagination. We have developed the first fully engineered and finest audio system and visual system that has ever existed. My name is David Riddle. I've been an independent inventor, designer, manufacturer of custom tools for professionals working in all technical fields. I'm also an Emmy Award-winning recording engineer. I have been designing audio equipment for more than 50 years. And I'd like you to introduce you to my business partner, Dan Seifert. My partner, Danny, designed JBL's most successful product in their entire existence. It is still the flagship of their product line. Dan, tell us a little bit about the development of that very successful audio system.
Yeah, that was known as synthesis. The original concept, this was at the infancy of home theater. And at the time, there was this new marketing channel, which is known as integrators, people who put together all of the associated equipment, integrate it into a room, and sell that to a customer as a bundled product. The problem was, many times the equipment was not compatible. It came from multiple manufacturers and sometimes worked, sometimes didn't. So our idea was to have an integrated system from one supplier, so it's a turnkey home theater system installed by the integrator. But we wanted to take it to the next level because even the integrator can't control the room that it's being put in. They have some influence, but not enough. So I introduced the idea or suggested the idea that we calibrate the system to work as well as possible, particularly in low frequencies, with the room as it is, the size, the shape, the overall design, all of which has a very large influence over the final sonic product. And really, until we did this work, there was no mitigation process to deal with it. So,
are you telling me that the idea was to send an individual technician out to every single installation and include it in the price?
Well, that's what I proposed. I said, we need a measurement system that can be operated by a technician. He doesn't have to be an engineer, doesn't have to, you know, he just has to be able to follow instructions on the screen and it'll walk him through a calibrator, and then it's an automated equalization system, computer controlled. And that's what we worked on for a number of years. And when we went to market with it, it was an enormous success because it was at least 10 years ahead of anybody else. Nobody was doing anything like it at that time.
And that really was the seed of Infinite Environments, because Danny realized, as good and as successful as that audio system was, it still didn't meet all of the requirements that Dan and his ear and mind knew could exist. And that started a while ago, where we developed the very first fully engineered audio system. It's never existed anywhere on this planet where every single component we engineered and designed from scratch.
Yeah, that is true. That is correct.
We the only thing we didn't engineer and design are the carpeting and the screws that hold it together. It's that simple. And no matter what we say it does, until you experience it, you will know for absolute certainty that you've never experienced sound the way that you experience it in the Infinite Environments sonic spaceship. The various applications for the Infinite Environments sound reproduction facility are fourfold. Number one, for very well-heeled consumers who want to possess the absolute finest audio theater system in the world, they can purchase an Infinite Environments theater for their own personal use.
Yes, and the other application is simulations. For example, flight simulators, driving simulators, things like that where...
you mean like race car
racing? Race car, yes, driving simulators for race cars. Things like that.
And police work, to be able to train policemen in an actual acoustic environment where they're going to be confronting with firefights.
Correct. Yeah, all of those things which really you need the dynamics, you need the a realistic sound level in order to reproduce a believable scenario so that they don't feel like they're just playing a game.
Well, and, you know, and the thing that we haven't mentioned yet is that this is the only audio system on the Earth that produces audio up to 136 dB SPL from 8 cycles to beyond audibility. No other audio system goes that low a frequency. And we have over 20,000 watts with 32 subwoofers producing that level of visceral impact to the people inside of infinite environments. And you know, live musical productions, whether it be theater or concerts,
A remote concert experience is really a big one.
Well, it's the first time in history that we can transmit high-definition 2D and 3D video and multi-stream digital audio without any degradation anywhere on the planet. There's just no venues available that anybody's going to pay any money. They're not going to go to see a concert at a regular movie theater because the audio quality is so poor. And so now they will be able to come into a satellite infinite environments theater, and they will have an experience like they've never had at a live concert because of the fact that they are going to have a more intimate and more powerful sound that even the people in the original venue where this was being recorded and transmitted never had. They didn't have this kind of experience because it depends on where they were sitting and how good the sound mixer and how good the audio system was in that particular venue. Yeah. It varies all over the map.
There are live streaming services right now that bring you multi-channel live concerts, and you know, obviously for a subscription fee. And I think that that's potentially a big market because they record those programs, so you don't even have to necessarily be there when it's live, and it's better audio experience than the live experience.
It's purely the simple laws of practical physics, just simple physics that disallow this level of audio reproduction to happen ever before in the history of sound.
Well, commercial theaters will really benefit enormously because, for once, you could sit in almost any seat in the theater and still get an excellent performance where you're not so close to one speaker that's all you hear, or you're so far away from the left front speaker that you can't hear dialogue coming from there. All those kinds of things are completely mitigated by this system. The spread and the so-called sweet spot is now the entire room, and that's where I think commercial theaters would really benefit much more than they do from their current systems with multiple point source speakers. Those are just not...
Well, you know, again, no one can understand what we're talking about until they actually enter into an infinite environments theater and experience for the first time. All I can tell you is this, is that for the owner of the theater, the ability to show movies over and over again, movies from way in the past, the audio experience will be enhanced dramatically, even with films that are 50 years old. The characteristics of, in fact, one of the demos I do in this room is to show the 1939 Wizard of Oz. And when people see the Wizard of Oz and hear the enhancements that were made to the original soundtracks through digital signal processing, they will absolutely experience something they've never experienced. Watching that movie our whole lives, until you see it in the infinite environment theater, you will know that you've never seen the movie. One of the rapid return on investments for developers is gaming theaters. That is where people will rent by the hour between $40 and $60 an hour to be inside of the infinite environment space with virtual headsets and the complete visceral component of an actual battle scene, and carrying handheld recoiling weapons. I guarantee lines would be around the block, and the return on investment for someone to open a Infinite Environments gaming environment would be in a mini mall or up to a theme park area. The return on investment is so short, it's less than a year. That's how fast the ROI is. you have an open invitation to come to the Infinite Environment Sonic Spaceship anytime. We're based in Southern California, and I only need a 10-minute notice. You come, I will give you a demonstration, and I guarantee you will be way beyond what you ever anticipated would occur. And it will change your life forever.